Hi again, Penn fans. Welcome to the first edition of the Karin Brower Corbett Show for the 2011 season. Welcome.
Thanks.
We're here today to talk about the unveiling of the 2011 schedule for the Quakers, the four-time defending Ivy League champions. Take the field again in late February of the next calendar year, but talking a little bit about the schedule, daunting non-conference slate as always for the Quakers, three of the top three seeds from last year's NCAA tournament, and including both members of the final game and defending champion Maryland. What goes into putting together a tough schedule like that?
Well, we look at the season before and kind of see who did well, and we want to have a good strength of schedule when it comes down to the tournament and who they decide to take. And so, obviously, we do get an automatic bid for the Ivies, but you also want to have a lot of good outside competition so that you're prepared for the tournament but also get seeded well and hopefully get chosen if you don't win the Ivies. So, clearly, we added Duke to the schedule this year, so we have three ACC teams, which is always a tough conference, and that'll only make our strength of schedule better. And then we have Northwestern. We added Rutgers. We really wanted to get some of the Big East schools, so we look to add them this year. And so I think that it's a very tough schedule, but will enable us to hopefully get a bid to the tournament and get a seed.
It's a good balance this year, it looks like, between road games for the non-conference and home. You know, two games in Philadelphia, Franklin Field against Drexel and North Carolina to start before you head out, and it allows you to, you know, get the team out away from campus a little bit and to bond a little, you know, before the season starts with some of those trips. What goes into, you know, is just kind of, you know, you want to put together, you know, even mix of that, or is it, you know?
Yeah, I think you want to balance. We don't want to travel too much. Luckily, yeah. Where we're located, we don't have to travel as much as some places, being mid-Atlantic, but we do have far trips to North Carolina or to Dartmouth, depending on the year. This year, we fly to Northwestern, so you sort of want to balance that out, obviously having their academics being important. But I think for spring break, you know, that kind of changes for us. This year, Harvard is away on spring break and Hofstra's away on spring break. So although we don't go anywhere glamorous and warm, you know, we need to play games. So we're looking forward to going up to Long Island. We haven't played in Long Island since I've actually been here. So we have a couple Long Island kids on my team, and I'm excited to go up there and hopefully get some more of those recruits to come in and see us play. And then up at Harvard, clearly cold, not the best place to go in March. For spring break, but we like to play the Ivies earlier. I think we all have that same schedule where we get to start February 1st, a little bit later than the other schools. So pushing the Ivies earlier is sort of my, you know, what we want to do as Ivy coaches. So so that's a good trip. But I think that having Duke at the end of the season, it is home this year, but hopefully that'll end up being a great end of the regular season schedule if we can keep that game there.
Sure. You talked a little bit about the Ivy League schedule, you know, the home opener with Harvard. You guys are four-time defending league champions. You've, you know, sailed the waters of the Ivy League schedule, you know, successfully for the last four seasons, won the Ivy League tournament in its first edition last season. So it's kind of, you know, it's, I think, fair to say that the Quakers, you know, have the target on them as the team to beat in the conference of the recent era. And you know, what does that message do you send to your team about they got to be up for all seven of those games, you know, each time they step on the field in Ivy League play?
Right, no question. I think that, you know, we want to win the Ivy League championship. We'd like to host it again, and we want that automatic bid. And I think the league is going to do really well this year. I think we were all disappointed that only one team made it to the tournament last year. And I think you're going to see a big difference in the league this year. Harvard, I think, is going to be very good. Dartmouth has a lot of juniors and seniors this year. They kind of have the experience on their side, and Princeton had a great freshman class that last year and another one this year. And Cornell came on strong at the end of last season with a really good sophomore class that was just sort of struggled in the beginning of the season just because they were young, but they really came into their own at the end of the season and you know, gave Dartmouth a hard time in the tournament. So I think they're going to be a veteran team as well, and I think we're kind of the young ones this year. But we have a great leadership in Aaron Brennan and Julia Giordano and Carolyn Pollard, who have had a lot of experience on the field, and you know, we do bring that we know how to win, and I hope that we can teach the freshmen that and you know, start off on a good note on our first Ivy game. But it's going to be tough. But you know, we're not looking at this as a rebuilding year. We want to win.
Yeah. Speaking of rebuilding, it's, you know, touch upon the graduating class of 2010 that did a lot to change the way that this program is looked upon from the outside, with, you know, the four NCAA tournament runs. You know, they're a great class. You know, they've moved on, and you're bringing in 11 newcomers, 10 freshmen, and one sophomore transfer. You know, what's it been like to kind of, you know, like you said, not rebuild, but reload through the early portion of the fall?
Yeah, I mean, I think a lot of it is sort of teaching the newcomers what our culture is about, and you know, they've been working really hard. The upperclassmen have done a really good job of acclimating them to the team and bonding with the team. We've been doing a lot this fall with that, and we've been able to work in our small groups, individuals, and I'm really impressed with this class. This class is the most talented class that we've ever had. College lacrosse is very different than high school lacrosse, but they're picking it up quicker than any class has ever done that, especially defensively. And I think we typically, since I've been here, always had at least one freshman start, but mostly one freshman. I think this year we're going to have a lot of freshmen play, and that's exciting.
Yeah, it's always good to have some competition and, you know, make sure practice is just as tough as the games. And the defense has always been the hallmark of the Quakers when they take the field, right, you know, over the last 4 or 5 years. Well, good luck, you know, through fall and fall scrimmages and practice and getting the team in shape for when the calendar switches and February hits and the games begin for real. I'm sure we'll be checking in throughout the winter months as the team prepares for the season.
Great, thanks.
For more information on Penn women's lacrosse, all Penn sports, be sure to check the home of the Penn Sports Network at PennAthletics.com.